Good morning, dear cadets. So before starting today's video, I would like to rectify one thing in the video of 26 September. Okay, what is the rectification? The rectification is, this is NaClO3. This is sodium chlorate. What is this one? Sodium chlorate. Okay, and this one KClO3, this is potassium chlorate. Potassium chlorate. Okay, in that day video, now spelling was wrong. Chlorate spelling is CHLORATE. Similarly here also. So please rectify this one. That is on the video of 26 September. Rest everything is okay. So now coming back to the today's topic. What is the today's topic? The topic name of today's is oxo acids of halogen. So we have studied the oxo acids of phosphorus. We have studied the oxo acids of sulfur, oxo acids of nitrogen. Okay. Now oxo acids of halogens. So halogen means fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Okay. So what is the meaning of oxo acids? Already I told you there are two types of acids, hydra acids and oxo acids. Hydra acids means the acid which contains hydrogen along with one more atom. Okay. Oxo acids means along with that concerned atom, hydrogen and oxygen both will be there. Like H2SO4, that is the oxo acids of sulfur. HNO3, oxo acids of nitrogen. H3PO3, oxo acids of phosphorus. So if you see clearly here, along with the concerned atom means phosphorus, sulfur and nitrogen, hydrogen and oxygen is also present. So same is the case with the halogen. So how many halogens are there? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. And I have summarized their oxo acids. Fluorine is forming only one oxo acids, that is HOF, or you can write this one HFO. Okay, remember, whenever you are writing the formula of oxo acids of halogen, between hydrogen and halogen at least one oxygen must be there. Okay, just see here, this can be known as HOCl or this can be written SClO, but this form is most reliable form while writing the structure. So always remember, whatsoever oxo acids name or formula you are writing, between hydrogen and halogen put one oxygen, essentially. Okay, like here, just see, HOBR, this can be written HBRO, but while writing the structure you should write in this way. When I will explain you the structure, at that time I will tell you what is the importance of putting one oxygen between hydrogen and halogen. Same is the case with here, HOI or HIO. Now what is the oxidation state of fluorine here? Plus 1. Okay, what is the oxo acids of here? Means chlorine, plus 1. Here also bromine, plus 1. Here also plus 1. Okay, what about this one? Here oxidation state of chlorine is plus 3. Now second one of bromine is not known. Similarly, second of iodine is also not known. Chlorine here HOClO2 plus 5. Here HOClO3 plus 7. So HOClO2 can be written like that or can be written SClO3. But once again I am telling you, one oxygen you must put here. Same is the case here. This is plus 3. Here also plus 3. Not plus 3. This is plus 5. Here also plus 5. Okay. Now the last one, plus 7. Here also plus 7. Here also plus 7. Okay. So these are the oxo acids of halogens. What is the name of this one? Fluorous acid. What is the name of this one? Fluorous acid, hypofluorous acid. Okay, I am writing here, this side I am writing. Okay, let me delete this one. Hypofluorous acid, hypofluorous acid. Hypochlorous acid. What is the name of this one? Hypochlorous acid. Hypochlorous acid. This is hypobromous acid. Hypobromous acid. What is the name of this one? Iodous acid. Okay. Now what about this one? This is hypochlorous. This is chlorous acid. What is this one? Chlorous acid. Now second of bromine is not known. Similarly, second of iodine is not known. This is chlorous. What is the name of this one? Chloric acid. Chloric acid. What is the name of this one? Perchloric acid. Perchloric acid. Perchloric acid. Now what is the name of this one? Bromic acid. Bromic acid. This is perbromic. What is this one? Perbromic acid. This is iodic acid. Iodic acid. Okay. And what is the name of this one? Periodic acid. I am writing here. Periodic acid. Okay. So their name and oxidation state you have seen. Okay. Is there any problem now? So this is hypochlorous. This is hypochlorous. This is hypobromous. This is hypoiodous. Second one is chlorous. Third one is chloric. Last one is perchloric. HClO4. Similarly, this is hypobromous. Now, bromous is not there. Bromic, perbromic. Similarly, hypoiodous. Iodous is not here. Iodic, periodic is there. Okay? So, these are the oxo acids of halogen. I hope that you have got the name, including their oxidation state. Okay? So, one thing is clear. The oxidation state of halogen in their oxo acids is plus 1. Okay? Now, here there is a iodine always exhibit minus 1 oxidation state. So, here also fluorine is minus 1, not plus 1. So, this is the oxo acids of fluorine. Only one known oxo acids of fluorine where oxidation state of fluorine is minus 1 only, not plus 1. Okay? In rest every cases, the oxidation state of halogen is plus 1, plus 3, plus 5 and plus 7. Okay? So remember, means once again it is proved that fluorine is the only halogen which always exhibit minus 1 oxidation state. It never exhibit the positive oxidation state. Okay? So earlier I wrote here plus 1 in the flow of these oxo acids. But remember, here also fluorine is minus 1 only in HOF. Okay? Now there is one more question here. Now it is obvious question, just try to understand. Chlorine is forming the oxo acids in all the four positive oxidation state, that is plus 1, plus 3, plus 5 and plus 7. Okay? But similarly here also bromine 3, iodine 3. Okay? But fluorine is forming only one oxo acid, that is hypochlorous acid. The question is here, why is only one oxo acid of fluorine is known? Try to understand. There is only and only one oxo acid of fluorine, that is hypochlorous acid. In hypochlorous acid, only one acid is known. Reason? Now try to understand. In oxo acids of halogen, what is there? In addition to the halogen atom, hydrogen and oxygen should be there. You know that the fluorine size is very small. It cannot accommodate hydrogen and oxygen together. So hardly this is HOF is known, and that too unstable. It is unstable. It is not a stable acid. Okay? So this is the first reason is due to small size of fluorine, only one oxo acid of fluorine is known. Second one is high electronegativity. Now you may ask, sir, how high electronegativity is responsible for responsible for the abundance of or presence of one oxo acids of fluorine. Try to understand. Their structure would be like that. HOF. So fluorine electronegativity is very high. Okay. So it will attract the shared paired electron towards itself. Not only between O and F. Whatever bond pair electron is present between H and O also it will attract towards itself. So just see, this HO bond will become very very weak. So stability will be less. Neither stability, sometime what would be there? More number of oxo acid will not be formed. Because fluorine is more electronegative, then what it will do? It will attract all those electrons. So when it will attract all those electrons, where the formation of that compound is possible? At least between H and O electron should be present, then only compound will be generated or formed. Here what is there? Fluorine is so high electronegative that it will attract the electron which is present between H and O. That is why more number of oxo acids of fluorine is not known. So because of these two reasons, only one oxo acids of fluorine is known. I hope that you have got now. Now some other aspects of oxo acids of halogens are needed, like structure, okay, what is their nature and what is their acidic order strength. That is the most important. And now just see the structure. So I will explain you the structure of oxo acids of fluorine. Hypochlorous, chlorous, chloric, perchloric. Both formula I wrote here. This is plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 7. Just see. Already I told you that between, whenever you are writing the structure, between hydrogen and halogen, one oxygen must be there. So just see. HOCl. Okay. Now here what is there? 2, 4, 6. Okay. Seventh one electron here make bond pair. Now here 2 and 4. Now just see, the structure is completed, octet is completed or not? 2, 4, 6, 8. Now octet of everyone is completed. Okay, so this is the structure. Same way you can make the bromous and iodic acid also. Only one change is required. Where Cl you have written, just write Br. And in place of this one, you can write I also. Okay, structure is same only. So that is why between H and Cl or halogen atom, oxygen must be there. If you write O this side, then you can't complete the octet. If you write oxygen after this one, suppose you are writing like that, H, C, L and O. Okay, so it is very very difficult to form the structure, because if you are writing in between oxygen and hydrogen chlorine, so chlorine has to be divalent, and you know chlorine is never divalent. Okay, that is why Cl should be, means halogen atom should be at the end. Okay, second one is like that, HOCl. Okay, now here double bond O. Okay, double bond O. Now just see here. Now here how many lone pair electron is there? 1, 2, 3. Okay. So one pair you just give to this one. So when you give this one, then here how many pair will be left? 2 pair. Now just see. 2, 4, 8. Octet is completed. 4, 6, here 4, 6, 8, 10. More are there or not? That is why instead of double bond, you put one coordinate bond. Now just see, the octet is completed. Okay, octet is completed. Now already I told you there is no distinction between coordinate bond and double bond in modern chemistry. Even if you are putting here double bond, that is also not a problem. But that would be the violation of octet rule. That is why you should write here coordinate bond R. Here write positive, here write negative. If you don't want to put this sign, okay. So this is the second structure. This is hypochlorous acid. This is chlorous acid. What about this one structure? The structure is HO, HO, here, 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 what is there? Cl. Now just see, one coordinate bond, another coordinate bond, one lone pair will be here. Okay, now here 2, 4, 6, here also 2, 4, 6 over, completed, no problem at all. Now what is the next one? Now the next one is here, just see, this is hypochlorous, chlorous, chloric, perchloric. The next one is HO, here what is there? Cl. Now here one oxygen coordinate bond, another oxygen coordinate bond, another oxygen here. So here 2, 4, 6, here also what is there? 2, 4, 6, here also 2, 4, 6, correct? Octet is completed or not? If you are having any problem, so you can make like that. This is O, here 2, 4, 6, okay? Now put here 2, 4, 6. So this is the structure of HClO4 or HOClO3, okay? No problem at all? Yes. So this is the structure. Same way you can make the structure of oxo acids of bromine and iodine, okay? So this is the structure. Remember their structure. Sometime they ask in 1 mark question, what is the structure of this one, okay? Any particular, especially this one, HClO4 is very important. Most of the time they ask the structure of this one only. So I hope that you have got the structure. Same way you can write, now suppose bromine. So in place of Cl write bromine. In place of Br you can write I. So now structure is completely completed. Okay. The most important aspect is now acidic strength. Now acidic strength, okay? So there are two category of oxo acids of halogen. Oxo acids where the oxidation state of all the halogen is same. Like here, just see, this is minus 1, this is plus 1, this is plus 1, this is plus 1. So the oxidation state is almost similar. Now barring fluorine, fluorine is exceptional, okay? But oxidation state is same only, halogen atom, okay? Then what is the order of electronegativity of these halogen atoms? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, okay? So now I wrote here the acidic strength order. Hypochlorous acid is most acidic. What is this one? This is most acidic, most acidic. This one is least acidic, least acidic, okay? Now try to understand here, why? Just try to understand. The fluorine is most electronegative, so it will attract the electron which is present between O and F, okay? Not only this electron, it will attract the bond pair electron which is present between H and O, okay? Then what would be there? This HO bond will become weak and removal of H positive become easy. Chlorine is less electronegative than fluorine. It will also do the same. But as compared to fluorine, their electron attraction capacity is less. What about bromine? Bromine will also do the same. But as compared to chlorine, in less magnitude. Okay? So all halogen atom, what they are doing? They are attracting the electron which is present between HO, means bond pair electron which is present between H and O, resulting into removal of H positive, okay? So here I wrote, greater the electronegativity of halogen atom, greater will be the tendency to attract shared paired electron present between HOX bond, resulting into weaker will be HO bond and removal of H positive become easy. Since F is most electronegative and I is least, hence HOF is more acidic and HOI is least, okay? So when the oxidation state of halogen is similar, you can explain the acidic order strength. This is acidic order strength. Acidic order strength. You can explain on the basis of electronegativity, okay? And now try to understand, when oxidation state of oxo acids of halogen is different, then what should be there? Now same order you can apply for. Now just try to understand. Suppose I wrote here HO, okay, I will just write here, means just see, first one is chlorous, hypochlorous, chlorous, chloric. So just see, in case of chlorus, bromine and iodine is not forming. Okay, but third number means hypochlorous, chlorous, chloric. Chloric is also there, bromic is also there, iodic is also there. Okay, so we'll write that one. There also order would be same only. Order would be same only. Now just see here. I took here third one. That is chloric, bromic and iodic. Just see, this is there. Here also oxidation state is similar only. Chlorine plus 5, bromine plus 5, iodine plus 7. So this is the only order. Okay. So just see, acidic strength when oxidation state of halogen is same. So electronegativity difference is the point on basis of that we can explain the acidic order strength. Suppose I took HOClO4. So just write down here one O. Here also you can write one more O. Here also you can write here one more O. Okay. Now oxidation state is plus 7. Here also plus 7. Here also plus 7. Order would be same. So if different halogens, if they have got the same oxidation state, so the acidic order strength can be explained on the basis of electronegativity difference. Okay, have you got this one or not? Just see, three order I explained you. That is the hypochlorous, hypobromous and hypoiodous. Similarly, second I did not take because bromine and iodine is not forming. Third I took, that is chloric, bromic, iodic. Next one is perchloric, perbromic, periodic. Okay. Now acidic strength when oxidation state of halogen is different. Okay. So just see. So now just see here, acidic strength when oxidation state of halogen is different. So just see, just view from here first, this one and this one. Okay, just see, HOCl here chlorine is plus 1, here chlorine is plus 3, here plus 5, here plus 7. So what is the acidic order strength? The acidic order strength is this one. Here this is the highest one, this is the least one. And here I wrote one sentence: greater the number of oxygen atom, greater will be the delocalization of negative charge, hence greater will be the acidic strength. This is the key point to understand the acidic order strength of oxoacids of halogen when the oxidation state is different. Okay. Greater the number of oxygen atom, greater will be the delocalization of negative charge, hence greater will be the acidic strength. Okay. Now suppose you have not got that key point, now try to understand. We'll explain this one on the basis of conjugate acid base pair strength, that is the Brønsted-Lowry concept. Okay. Just see, this is HClO. Okay. It delocalized, means it dissociate into H positive plus ClO negative. What is the name of this one? Hypochlorous ion. Okay. So HClO and ClO single negative, they are conjugate acid base pair. Last year I taught you, between conjugate acid and base pair there is a difference of one proton. Here one proton is more, H is there. Here proton is not there, that is why they are the conjugate acid base pair. Similarly here HClO2, okay, so HClO2 dissociate into H positive plus ClO negative. So this was hypochlorous, this is chlorous ion. Okay, chlorous ion. So now try to understand, HClO2 and ClO2, they are the conjugate acid base pair. Now just see here only one oxygen atom is there. So if oxygen want to delocalize their negative charge, now it hasn't got any option because only one oxygen is there, that negative charge will be present on that oxygen atom only. So ClO negative least stable due to delocalization of negative charge on one oxygen atom. Here negative charge can be delocalized over two oxygen atom, because in chlorous ion two oxygen atom is there. So as compared to their stability, ClO2 single negative stability, the stability of ClO negative is less because here one oxygen atom is there, here two oxygen atom is there. Now just see here, as ClO3, same way conjugate acid base pair, here ClO3 single negative, what is the name of this ion? Hypochlorous chlorous chloric ion. Here three oxygen atom is there. Now negative charge can be delocalized over three oxygen atom. Okay, so this their stability is greater than ClO2 single negative stability. Okay, now the last one I wrote this side. Okay, this is just see this one. Okay, ClO4 H positive, ClO4 single negative. So ClO4 and ClO4 single negative, they are conjugate acid base pair. I wrote here ClO4 single negative, delocalization of negative charge on four oxygen atom, hence they are most stable. Among these four, which is having more number of oxygen atom, which ion is having more number of oxygen atom? ClO4 single negative. So delocalization of negative charge is more. Okay, hence stability of ClO4 negative will be more. Okay, so ultimately greater the number of oxygen atom, greater will be the delocalization of negative charge, hence greater will be the acidic strength. Now there is one more point I think you are not getting. What is the meaning of delocalization of negative charge over the oxygen atom? Just I will explain that one, then we'll sum up. So dear cadets, now see the meaning of delocalization. Okay, the first one is ClO. Okay, it will dissociate H positive plus ClO negative. I'm now just see Cl, for us this ClO O negative is important. I'm now just see what is their structure. Their structure would be like that, ClO 2-4-6 lone pair of electron. Now this oxygen atom has got the negative charge. Okay, now second structure is not possible, because if you will try hard to make the second structure, you have to make like that only, because oxygen is not there. But in second case, ClO2 case, just see H positive ClO2 negative, two oxygen atom is there. So just see in the structure number first, just see clearly here Cl double bond O. You can put here double bond, there is no difference between coordinate bond and double bond. And this is single bond O, 2-4-6, that is the lone pair of electron. So now where negative charge is there? On this oxygen atom negative charge is there. Please be careful. Now this is having negative charge. Okay, now if I shift this electron here and shift this electron here, I may have the second structure. Now here double bond is there and here single bond is there, and oxygen has acquired negative charge. So just see here, first structure, in first structure negative charge on this oxygen atom, in second structure negative charge on this oxygen atom. So negative charge is delocalized over two oxygen atom. Same is the case with this one, ClO3 negative. Here one by one, now just see on this oxygen atom negative charge is there. Now in second structure, in this case, in third structure on this oxygen atom, you just see here negative charge is there. Okay, charge is there or not? So in this case, what is there? Over three oxygen atom negative charge is, negative charge is delocalized. Now in ClO4 case, if you see carefully, means one by one, just see here negative charge is there. Now in second structure, here negative charge, in third one here, in fourth one here, this is the negative charge. Okay, please be careful while making the structure. Always remember, while making these conjugate structure, you should put the double bond between chlorine and oxygen. Okay, then only you can explain over. You can make the resonance hybrid also, but that is not required. Just I want to show you the delocalization of negative charge. So greater the number of oxygen atom, greater will be the delocalization of negative charge, and greater will be the stability. Now just see here, I make this arrow small arrow and this side greater. Since this one is the least stable, then equilibrium will be shifted in this direction. Means HClO doesn't want to dissociate into H positive and ClO negative. Okay, it wants to be in this form. So when it is not dissociating, so it will not furnish H positive. Hence, it will be the least acidic. Now in HClO4 case, just see, equilibrium is in forward direction. Backward direction, that small arrow is there. Means HClO4 wants to be in this form, H positive, ClO4 negative. ClO4 single negative is most stable. Means it doesn't require H positive. Okay, this themselves is satisfied. So it always wants to be in this form, ClO4 negative form. It doesn't want to get H positive. Means HClO4 always want to dissociate into H positive and ClO4 negative. Okay, so equilibrium is shifted in this direction. That is why it wants to be in this form. It means this is most acidic. I wrote here, ClO4 single negative is most stable. Hence HClO4 is most acidic. So I hope that you have got the acidic order strength of oxo acids of halogen when their oxidation state is different. Always remember this one sentence: greater the number of oxygen atom, greater will be the delocalization of negative charge. Hence greater will be the stability of oxo acid, or greater will be the acidic order strength. Once again listen: greater the number of oxygen atom, greater will be the delocalization of negative charge on oxygen atom. Hence greater will be the acidic strength that is there. In HClO4 case, at 4 oxygen atom, 1 by 1 negative charge is delocalized. Okay, while in ClO negative, only at 1 oxygen atom negative charge is delocalized. Okay, so I hope that you have got this one. Same is the case with, suppose here you have taken HBrO, HBrO2, HBrO3, same is the case there also. Okay, same concept, only one difference would be there. Wherever you have written the Cl, there you have to write Br. Similarly, if iodine you have taken, so where Cl or Br is there, you have to write I. But basic point of explanation of acidic order strength is same only. So I hope that you have got, this is the most important. Now they just in one mass question they will give you the oxo acids of halogen having same oxidation state or different oxidation state. They will tell you arrange according to increasing order or decreasing order of their acidic strength. So when you know the point, you can write very easily. So once again, greater the number of oxygen atom, greater will be the delocalization of negative charge on oxygen atom, and greater will be the acidic strength. This is the rule when oxidation state of halogen is different in different oxo acids. And when the oxidation state of halogen is same, then what is there? Electronegativity difference is playing the important role. Greater the electronegativity, greater will be the acidic order strength. Okay? So dear cadets, next topic is interhalogen compound. So today only I will introduce you this one. What are the interhalogen compound? So halogens are basically fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So the compound which is formed between two or more halogen atom. Okay, means within the group only. Interhalogen compound is the characteristics of halogen group, because you might not have seen that other group elements, they themselves are reacting with each other. Have you seen that boron is reacting with aluminium or aluminium is reacting with gallium? No, you have not seen. Now similarly, now suppose lithium is not reacting with sodium, but in halogen case what is happening? They between them or among them only compound is formed. Means fluorine can react with chlorine, chlorine can react with bromine, bromine can react with iodine and vice versa. So interhalogen compounds are those compounds which are formed by the combination of two or more halogen atom itself. So the compounds of two or more halogen atom on the basis of their atomic size and electronegativity difference. So these two points are very important. On the basis of atomic size and electronegativity difference. Okay. So of course halogen, they will react with means themselves among their group only, but their reaction is based on, their combination is based on atomic size and electronegativity difference. What is the general formula of interhalogen compound? X dash N. This is dash N. What is the meaning of X? X is halogen atom. X is the halogen atom having big size and less electronegativity. Always remember, this X is the halogen atom and its size is big and electronegativity is less. What about X dash? X dash means halogen atom of small size and having more electronegativity. So always remember, X is the halogen atom of big size and small electronegativity. X dash is the halogen atom. X dash is the halogen atom of small size and having more electronegativity. And what about N? N is the number of halogen atom. Whose number? X dash halogen atom. And its value depends upon the size of X. What would be the value of N? It depends upon the size of X. Greater the size of X, greater will be the value of N. Means if their size, I size is more, X size is more, the value of N will also be more. Now, types of interhalogen compound. So, interhalogen compound can be classified on two bases. Number one, on the basis of nature. On the basis of nature, they are three types, neutral, negative and positive. And on the basis of oxidation state of X, they are of means XY type, XY3 type, XY5 type, XY7 type. Will explain you tomorrow. That's all for today. Duration is completely completed. Just see. So please remember whatever today I taught, all are important. Just remember this one. Thank you. So tomorrow I will complete the structure of interhalogen compound and some other thing. Probably tomorrow I will be able to finish the group number 17, and afterwards I will teach you the 18th group, and after finishing this one I will teach you the D block and F block elements, then coordination compound. So I hope that you are noting down, especially my complaint with one of the section that they are still not watching the videos. Okay. Now you see other videos, but please watch my video also, because ultimately teacher explanation is the matter and I will be held responsible for everything. So thank you.